immediately what it will do, it will come out of that program. Okay, it will enter first enter into power saving mode. So the screen become the screen has become black. So power saving mode is on. So after some time, once again it will see nothing is happening. It will come out of that program automatically. It will happen. Okay. To explain this, I have taken the example of my mobile phone. You can do with the help of your mobile also. Now coming to our example. Okay. So this is the meaning of using here as jump here. You can use RET also. You can use end. It is up to you. Okay. Now, I hope this example is very clear, simple. So take the contents into a memory in a register. Take contents in another register. Multiply those two registers. Get back the result. But here we have a restriction that definitely you need to take in A and definitely you need to take in B, because once again the destination registers are A and B. Okay. Now, I hope this program is very clear. Coming to second program, so read the question, sir. Here it is available. Write a program to divide 75H with 12H. Okay. It is very easy. Simply you can take A in 75, B in 12 in B, divide A comma, divide AB, that will happen. But to add some extra thing, so because we have learned the how to multiply, to add something extra, I have mentioned the extension of this example program and store the quotient in remainder in R0 register and remainder in R1 register of bank 3. So before going to our main program, what I need to understand, I am using bank 3. If I have mentioned nothing means it is default bank is what, bank 0, but here I am mentioning bank 3. So how to initialize this thing? You remember PSW, program status word register, which is a bit addressable register. So in that I am selecting what, in that you have PSW3 and PSW4, so RS1 and RS0. So using these combinations you can select banks. So 00 will give you bank 0, 01 similarly, so 11 will definitely give you bank 3. So consider here, what is the instruction? We need to use divide AB. So what will happen? A divided by B, the result will be stored in A as well as in B. So quotient will be stored in A, remainder will be stored in B. So what is asked in our question? So you divide these two numbers, you will get the results here in A and B, but you need to store the result into quotient which is available in A. You need to move that into R0 and you need to move this B content into R1. It is very simple. Okay, first understand the question, divide and store. Okay, and after getting the result, you store them in some registers R0 and R1. To activate bank 3, what is the condition, sir? You need to go to PSW and program these bits as 11 to select bank 3. I think it is very clear. Now I'm going to program part. Here the diagrammatic explanation is not necessary. You can directly understand. So how to start, sir? I want to set PSW3 and PSW4 to select bank 3. So for that I am writing the instruction set B, set the bit PSW.3, set bit PSW.4. So it is 11. That means bank 3 is selected. Okay. Now move A comma hash 75. Hash 75, it is what? A will be loaded with 75 data. Move B comma hash 12. What is happening, sir? B is loaded with 12. Now what you are writing? Divide A comma, sorry, no comma here. Divide AB. Okay. The result, what you will get? You will get the result in quotient in A and remainder in B. So move, what you need to, where you need to move the quotient? Quotient is available in A. You need to move in R0. So what is the instruction? Move R0 comma A. Similarly, move R1 comma B. Remainder will be moved into R1. So we are not worried with this thing. 75 divided by 2. What will be the answer? What will be the quotient? Simply, okay, you need to do this thing. Okay, I think this is clear. Simply, you are setting PSW.3, PSW.4 using set B instruction to select bank 3. Moving the contents into A, moving the content into B, the dividend and divider, and you are using the instruction divide AB. Results will be available, quotient will be available in A, remainder will be available in B. You are moving quotient into R0, moving remainder into R1. Okay. Once again, you are writing what to end the program here, as in here. So, what will happen? Initially, it will enter into infinite loop. It will realize that nothing is happening. So it will enter into power saving mode. Then it will end up this program. Okay, I think it is very, very clear. Now, in previous classes, we have seen add two numbers. So add two numbers available at locations 20H and 21H. But the same thing, I am repeating the same thing, but I am adding some extra part to this question. Okay, read the question. Write a program to add the contents of locations 20H and 21H. Okay, up to this we have discussed in our previous class. The extra part is now. And store the result in 23H location and carry in 23H location. Sorry, here it should be 22. Okay, there is a small mistake. The result should be stored in, result is nothing but sum. Sum should be stored in 22 location and carry should be stored in 23 location. Okay, now diagrammatic part is, it's up to you. You can go through this. Okay, you can start program directly. So I will explain, because here it is available, I will explain. 20H, you, what you will do, you will take the contents. So what you need to perform, the idea I am representing diagrammatically. So what you will do, sir, to add the two numbers, take the contents from that location into A, take the contents. Here it is not necessary. You can add this thing with the content directly, okay? A plus the contents available in this thing, and you will get the result sum. I will store this using move instruction to this particular location. Sum will be stored here, and carry will be stored here. But here you need to understand one thing. So carry is available. Carry can have two values, 0 or 1. So based on your result, it will set or it will reset. But we can't go with two possibilities. It is 0 or 1. So to avoid that confusion, simply I will assume. What I will assume, sir? I will assume that my carry is 0 initially. So where I need to store that thing, I will store that in some register. So I have taken a register R2. So see here, assume carry is stored in R2. I will consider this thing to reduce the task, to remove the confusion. Okay, the program starts. Okay, what you need to take here? First instruction is that I am clearing the contents of carry. Move R2, 00H. That means I am assuming carry is having 0. Now what I will do, sir? Move A, 20H, taking the contents into accumulator. Add A, 20H. Directly you can do this. What will happen here? The contents available in 21 will be added to A. Result will be stored in A. So I need to move the result into 22H. So move 22H, A. What will happen? The contents or the sum available here, it will be moved into 22H location. Okay. Now something extra. Because of this extra thing, you need to write some extra thing in your answer. Okay. Suppose the carry has not generated, you have not generated any carry, then what I will write? Jump if no carry to this skip label. So it will skip to, it will jump to this label skip. And what it will do, sir? Move 23, R2. That means the same carry, 00. Carry has been not generated. That means it is 0. So that thing will be loaded into 23, informing that carry value is what? 00. Suppose, okay, see once again. Because I am assuming that initially it was 0, I have done the operation, but in the result I have not got any carry. So how you will determine you have got the carry or not? By using this instruction, jump if no carry. If the carry is not generated, you will jump to this label skip, and what you will do? Now the carry is what? 0. So you will move 00 into our 23H location. Okay, and then you will perform here, jump here, it will go into infinite loop, program will end. Okay, now the second condition, suppose carry has generated, then what will happen? Jump if no carry to skip. Because carry has generated, it won't jump to this label, it will continue next instruction. What will happen? Increment R2. R2 now it becomes 0. R2 is carrying what? Contents of carry. Here increment 1 means carry has generated, R2 becomes 1. Now move 23H, R2. What will happen? 1 will be moved into 23H location. Okay. I think it is very, very clear. Okay, you can simply understand by writing the comments. The program is very easy. If carry is generated, you won't jump to skip, you will increment R2 and 1 will be moved into 23H. If carry is not generated, you will jump to skip location and simply what will move? You is what? 00 will be moved into 23H. I think this is very clear. Okay, I hope this is very clear. Is it enough up to this point, or shall I continue? See here, when I'm writing the same program, so I will inform something here. After that, I will ask the question if to continue or not. So, add program. So this will be in of three different formats. So first format is then your locations. You have selected locations. They are available in internal RAM. How you have decided, sir? 20H it is 8-bit address. 21H it is also 8-bit address. So you are doing addition of two contents which are pointing to internal RAM. What is the second possibility, sir? Second possibility is that so you will be pointing to external RAM locations of 16-bit address. That means two locations available in internal external RAM. There is a third possibility that one content is pointing to internal RAM, second content will be pointing to external RAM. Three cases will be available. So I have discussed with you the first case, that is two locations are available or in internal RAM itself. Coming to second thing, okay, second possibility is that the two locations are available in external RAM. Now you need to perform addition of these two things, and I will discuss third case, that is both are in some one content is internal, second content is in external. How to do these things? Okay, I will explain this part. Okay, I will explain this part, and then I will ask to continue or to stop, because this is also very easy, same thing but little bit extra, because you are dealing with 16-bit address. Our processor can take address of 1 byte at a time, so you need to do two things at a time.